it's an awesome name to say football cha-cha. Football cha-cha again. The kind of goals we've scored in the I-League and the ISL this year are world-class goals. If you don't give game time to your strikers and you keep on asking where's the next Sunil Chhetri, that's a very stupid question to ask. I'll tell you, who should be head of Indian football? जिसको जब इंडिया अफगानिस्तान या बांग्लादेश से हारता है, जिसको दर्द होती है ना यहाँ पे.
हेलो एंड वेलकम एवरीवन, दिस इज फुटबॉल चाचा. आई एम कार्तिक एंड वी हैव अनंत विद अस. Before we move on to our esteemed guest, we would like to say something about what Football Chacha is and who our esteemed guest here is tonight. So Football Chacha was basically started as a platform to indulge in intellectual football debate and to basically cater to footballing opinions across the globe. So when it comes to footballing opinions, our guest today has been known to have some bold ones. He is one of the most enigmatic personalities in Indian football and has been a bundle of energy that has been powering Indian football through various initiatives that he's had. So a few of his achievements have been, he's been the ex-owner of Minerva Punjab FC now. He's won I-League at every level, if I'm not wrong, at every age group. He is the owner of Minerva Academy, which has produced so many Indian footballing greats and young talents as well. And he could possibly be the next owner of East Bengal FC. So welcome Mr. Ranjit Bajaj. How have you been? How has the lockdown been for you?
Hi Karthikeya. Hi Anant.
Hi.
So much for having me, guys. It's a great pleasure to be on here on Football Chacha.
And all our pleasure.
It's an awesome name to say, Football Chacha. Football Chacha again. So guys, it's been great, but we're trying to learn how to live with the new norm. The new norm is the COVID-19, and hopefully they realize that if they can open movies for shoots for 50 days for 50 people, and they can open marriages for 50 people, they can definitely open up the academies. Because see, what's happening is we are losing out on the next generation of football players. Yes, the ISL will survive, probably I-League survive. But this generation who want to go and get into football will not be able to do it. They'll probably get into a non-contact sport because they will not stop playing. They will play. When you were 13, 14, 15, you have this bundle of energy. And if you're not being allowed to play football, you probably go and play cricket or anything else which is being allowed at this time. So, hopefully things are back to normal as soon as possible.
What we were wondering, sir, was that since the quarantine period, you've been pretty active on all your social interaction with your East Bengal news coming up, and Karthik also mentioned you got recommended for the Khel Puraskar, and that was
forgot to mention actually.
He forgot to discuss that.
So congratulations on that, sir.
Thank you. I hope the actual congratulations will come when we win it.
Exactly. You should. We hope you win. There's four of us who founded Football Chacha, and we did our research, and we were wondering what has Minerva Academy been up to since the last 4 months with
we've been up to so much. In fact, I think we've probably been one of the most busiest social media handles during this lockdown.
Right.
And starting from because we have an integrated campus and we've been able to create this artificial bubble there. And the people who are living in there are staying in there. And we've been able to hold blood donation camps, and we've been able to go and give food to the homeless and even to stray animals and stray dogs.
Sure.
And actually look after them in this while, because we have a dog shelter as well. Then we've been able to go out and now contact some foundations to go and help coaches, to go and help players, linesmen, groundsmen. Anybody like that who is in need at this time, which is probably 50% of our system, which is in need right now. We found a way they can contact a foundation, and that foundation is there to help them. So it's been a really busy time, because I've seen that, what I've seen is that, you know, when if I say something that people do listen, so I'm trying to take advantage of that and do it in a good way that, you know, I mean, I've also learned the hard way that you can keep on sitting there and abusing AIFF all you want, but right. That's not going to change them in any way because they are very hard-shaped. They are politicians, so
absolutely,
it's water off their back. So instead of that, we should all try in our own ways. It's not that we stop fighting against the injustices, but at the same time, we have to make our own efforts as individuals, whoever we are, to do that little bit we can. Like, for example, anyone who is probably sitting at home, doesn't know what to do, and you see some kids going and playing, go buy them a football, okay, and let them play. And that will probably inspire one of them to get that kick in one day when he's playing football that I want to go professional. But exactly. It wouldn't have happened if he wouldn't have been playing at that time.
Mm-hmm.
So there's little things we can do. Doesn't matter how much money you have. If you want to help the environment, you can go out and keep water for the dogs or even for the birds at this time. So if we have to see what we can do individually, and people don't realize individual efforts make a huge deal. Because, see, in Belgium, they are world number one right now. And their league system is nothing to talk home about. It's got nothing to do with like German league, or the English Premier League, or the Spanish league.
Yeah,
but exactly. They're able to produce the players. That's because the coaching system is right. And I am now worried that the coaches who are going to be affected the most by this pandemic are the ones who are at the base of our society. That means the E license, D license, and C license coaches, who would probably see B and A license coaches mostly. Either have an academy of their own, are doing well, or are employed by clubs or ISL clubs, and they get a certain coming.
Yeah.
Whereas it's more normally D and C licensed coaches who have these small academies in these villages, which are going to be affected the most. So hopefully we are working towards that.
That's wonderful, sir. That's wonderful to hear. I mean, I truly believe everyone should do their bit for the community, and looks like you're leading the charge there as well. So
doing my bit though.
Yeah, absolutely, sir. So, coming back to Minerva Academy, so we've researched a lot and we've heard you talking about your World Cup Vision 2034. So, keeping that in view, how is Minerva Academy looking at the players? What is the age group? What are the talents and the nitty-gritties that you look for, not just in players but in coaches to help hone that amount of talent?
See, I always believe that we Indians had it in us forever to get into the World Cup. It's just the lack of leadership and direction. It's not that suddenly Indians are good enough to be world champions in cricket. We've always been good enough, but we didn't have the system. Now, we are always going to be fighting for the top spot in cricket. Why? Because the system has become like this, that even if I go to a district ground, you'll have a super sopper. That is the machine which... Yeah. And that machine costs, 2 crores or 1.5 crores.
Mm-hmm.
And each district ground has it. It's because BCCI is giving the funds down to the state associations. It's not that AFF is not doing it. They don't have any money to give down. So I'm just saying they have the money, so they're doing it. Because of that, it's not now trying to look for the next Virat Kohli because they'll keep on being produced. So what we have to do is have a system. And then the basic factors which make Indians doubt ourselves is things like when they say that Indians don't have genes for power and stamina. Again,
Yeah.
That is the most common thing you hear about football and Indians. We don't have the height, we don't have the...
The only medals we get in Commonwealth or Asian Games are either in boxing or in wrestling or in weightlifting. Right.
Yes.
It's blasphemous to say that.
Or kisi mein milta hi nahi hai. So, which power, stamina, genes are you talking about? Then they say, you know, not enough Indians are playing football, you know. So, we don't have enough base. Well, 3 lakh, the population of Iceland is 3 lakh. And 3 lakh, like I keep on saying, humare Diwali ke mele mein hote. That's not a consideration. Then they say, why a lot of money, you know, rich nations can do it. Bullshit. Mm-hmm. Brazil is the nation which is is probably as poor as India. But they have been world champions so many times and they're still producing world champions. So that's not a thing we should talk about. Then they talk about, you know, in team games, Indians don't do well. That's not true. In hockey, we are again now competing in top 5. And in hockey, look at the nations we beat. We beat Holland or we compete with them on an equal basis. Or Spain, or England, or Germany, Argentina, South Korea, Japan, Australia. Look at the
top teams.
Look at their football teams.
Right.
So if we can compete with them in a big field, in a hockey game, we can definitely do it in a football game. So the only reason, what I saw was that our boys are being, we're starting serious football at a very late age. You can talk about youth development when you have these plans which come out from abroad, which I don't agree with, that in the ages of 6, 7, 8, 9, you can actually go easy and do train them 3 times a week. That's, yes, you can do that once you have a great, fantastic team. You can do that. But when you need to be a nation like ours trying to develop players, you need to train 5 times a week and you need to start at the age of 6, 7, 8, 9. And the aim is not to produce a team which is going to be good enough to beat other teams in the World Cup. The aim is to produce players.
Right.
Yeah.
For example, Belgium doesn't have the best league, but their players are playing in the best leagues in the world.
World-class.
The Kevin De Bruyne's of the world.
Right now, not because of their league. Their league sucks, being honest.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Their
players are playing in the best leagues. So the aim is that every year we take our boys who are now, after 2 years, that means when they'll be 8, 9, they'll go and play in an under-9 tournament and they'll play against the best teams which happen all over the world. So we have best clubs of the world, under-9. Yeah. The next year, under-10s, under-11s. Mm-hmm. So by the age of 15, we have 8 or 9 Indians who have been picked up by the Premier League academies of the world. And that is when they'll get a chance in the Premier League. So if we have 7 or 8 Indians playing in the Premier League, we'll definitely make it to the World Cup and the Asian Cup. That's no point even talking about it because we'll be there. But if you see, how do we not get there? Even if Sunil Chhetri scores 20 goals in the 20 goals, only 50 goals in the ISL, he'll still not be picked up by Man City.
Exactly.
Yeah, but if Sunil Chhetri is 12 years old and he scores 5 against Man City in a under 12 match, they'll pick him up immediately.
You've
got to make a difference where you know it'll count. You can't expect to wait till your league is good enough. See, making your
league won't happen.
Is not going to happen. If that had to happen, then China would have been at number one now.
Absolutely.
But they are nowhere even in the top 10 in Asia. I mean, they're having a problem qualifying for the World Cup now.
Yeah.
Spending money in your league is not the way, because the results will be very, very, very minute. Whereas if you want to have major results by spending the least amount of money, it's grassroots.
So, in extension to your comments, so Football Chacha here, what we aim to do is try to build a more inclusive community where girls, where young children, where older people start to get involved in the sport of football, because you see a lot of that happening with cricket already. So, but mereko kya lagta hai ki football as a sport is so... जैसे I used to play football till the age of 20-21, I got an ACL. So, I told my parents कि 1 लाख रुपए खर्चा है, उन्होंने बोला छोड़ दे, कॉलेज खत्म कर, जॉब ढूंढ और जाके काम कर. और मैं 4-5 साल से सिर्फ यही रोना बचा के बैठा हूँ कि यार घर वालों ने पैसा दिया नहीं, मैं पढ़ाई कर रहा हूँ, नौकरी लग गई, अब छोड़ो.
So this is a common joke. This is a common college.
I think that is something that you may see to be happening all over the country right now, because parents don't usually promote it. I think they should, because football ka bahut bada scope hai.
Culture. See, that's what a culture is. So culture is not only developed. When you say grassroots, I don't believe grassroots is only the kids. Grassroots means the kids' parents also.
Exactly.
Kids' parents are converted into football fans. The kid, no matter how much hard he tries, will be veered away from the sport. So, for example, you go to any US city and you see, and the city's population is 30,000 and they have a high school football game, the other football. But and out of 30,000, they'll have 28,000 people watching that game. And it's a high school football game. It's not about the quality which matters. It's the entire culture of the city getting behind its boys. The same sort of culture has to be brought in here. And unfortunately, it's not there in any sports. It's not even there in cricket. For example, if you call the I-League or the Santosh Trophy, the Ranji Trophy. In the Ranji Trophy, you don't see crowds, man. The same players are playing, but you don't see crowds there.
Yeah.
So what we need to do is make it as good as a viable, nowadays, viable as a timeout. That means if a father has a choice to spend 300 rupees to go to a movie, go to a football match or cricket match, he should have maximum fun at the football match. And unless the father enjoys, he will never bring the kid there. And that's what happens abroad. Abroad, it's the father who gets the kid in for the first time and then he gets into a habit and then it transfers to his kid. By the way, which is happening in Mohun Bagan, East Bengal, and that's how generations culture is there. So we will get there, but see, like you said, parents should encourage. Earlier, by in the 60s and 70s, parents used to really encourage kids for sports. And I'm talking about India. Why? Because there's an alternate source of employment. For example, football career, all parents know, even footballers know, is for 6 to 7 years, you're prime, and 2 to 3 years when you're making it, and 2 to 3 years on your way down. And this is when you, if you have no injuries whatsoever.
Right.
Which is, and like Anand has said, it's very, very, it's true, man, ACL and MCL, and that's your career over. So, they know this is their prime time, but what after that? Because that's a very minute part of their lives. And parents see that. So they see that there's too much risk involved here. But if you get a job on the basis of football, like you used to in Kerala Police, you used to in Punjab, in BSF, in CRPF, in AG Punjab, AG Haryana, AG all over, or customs, or income tax, you know, or Air India, they were institutional jobs. And institutes used to be giving those jobs because they wanted to do really well in the institutional leagues. The moment you stopped that, you stopped a very big chunk of people, especially, who are the people who really want to take up sports as a livelihood? They want to get out of poverty. That's their way out of poverty. So the only way now, before this ISL and I-League was really took off, I'm talking about 10 years back, the only way you made it as a footballer in India is if you play for the Indian national team. So, you can make it as a career. So, that means 20 people max or 15
out of a billion.
Yeah. Whereas now, you need to be either in an I-League club, second division or even ISL. You can make a career.
Yeah.
So, now careers are opening up. Now, you can make a career as an analyst, as a manager, as a team logistics guy, as you know, there's so many avenues which have opened up. And that's what we need. We need an entire ecosystem, not only the players, we need an ecosystem around it. For example, Football Chacha. Unless Football Chacha does well, football will not do well. Why? Because all these things are bloody interlinked.
Absolutely.
So the media of football has to do well and create jobs. So do the physiotherapy people, so do the analyst people, so do this. And that's now happening. They've seen that there are different avenues which can be got, avenues of earning which can be got from football. And hopefully now, if this continues, we can have a revolution. See, end of the day, I am not afraid at all, you know, even, I'm always look at the glass as half full, not half empty. Yeah. Why? Because I know for a fact, even if they want to fuck up football in India, IFF, they can't do it for long. Why? Because social media is so powerful. Every kid who's under 10 right now, I'm talking about the kids who are under 10, you ask them their favorite sports, 80% will say football. 10 to 15, it is 50-50. Above 15, it becomes 80-22 cricket. But that's changing now. Why? Because on social media, I mean, I want to be wearing a shirt of Abramovich. I don't want to be wearing Dhoni. Because that's the way kids are becoming now. They want to be rather with the international star than with the local current star.
Right,
because they're not local people. They're now international citizens.
True. So, sir, coming back to the point that you spoke about fans so enthusiastically and the culture of football where even the youngest kids in India are watching football. This is a small incident I wanted to share. There was a poster in Borussia Dortmund's stadium which said, my father brought me here and he was brought here by his father. I think that is the sort of culture you were talking about.
Yeah, so it's like legacies is brought down from generations.
Yeah, so when we talk about fans or football fans in India, we see that only a percentage of football fans are looking at Indian football. There's still a major chunk that is going to European football. So coming to the monetization of these fans, how important is it to have a drastic shift from European football to looking inwards into our own young stars, and how do you think that will happen? Do you think they're related?
I think it's just the weight of the first Mohammed Salah.
Exactly.
See, when Indians know we are the best in the world and we we can compete with them. As they start looking inwards as well, the Indian league will become really popular. The revolution will start. We've got 8 people from the Egyptian team playing in the Premier League in different clubs. And that all happened because one guy went and proved himself to be a world beater. And till 2 years ago in Egypt, football was not, yeah, it was the most popular sport, but it was not a religion. It's become a religion because of one man.
Mohamed Salah, yeah.
Yeah, the same way, football was not a religion till Tendulkar came in the picture and started thrashing everyone we knew about it.
And then
became a religion. And that now another god has been from Virat Kohli. So it's just a start we need. And it's about, see, we probably would have had that start if Sapreet Singh was an Indian. Because Sapreet Singh is just for Bayern Munich. Now
the second team, yeah.
See, the genes are totally the same. It's an Indian. Yeah. Totally born and brought up to a Punjabi family, eating Punjabi parantas, even sitting in New Zealand. The difference is that since the age of 8, 9, 10, he was playing with kids whose level of excellence was here and coached by coaches whose level of excellence was here. So for example, instead of Sapreet Singh, it would have been Shubham Sarangi there, or it would have been Himanshu Jangra there, he would have been playing for Bayern
Munich. Yeah. There's no difference actually.
So there's no difference in the genes because otherwise people like Sapreet Singh or Danny Bath or Nar Singh would have not got anywhere near the Premier League because he's got Indian blood.
Exactly. What I taking Karthik's question forward. So, मुझे लगता है कि this also depends on how the sporting structure is. For example, you've been connected with Punjab FC for so long. Do you think it would have made a bigger difference if we followed a German kind of model in club ownership? There's more of a connect.
That's possible, bhai. But that would have only been possible in Calcutta. It wouldn't have been possible in other places, probably in Kerala and Canada. Not even in Goa, because the fans are not that connected to their teams like they are in Calcutta or in Kerala. Hmm. See, if you have a culture where fans are willing to go out and spend money, that is the culture you need. So that is only there in Calcutta or in Goa. For example, in Punjab, even Kings 11 Punjab, the IPL team, is finding it difficult to fill up the stadiums if they have about 3 passes. In Delhi, and no football team has been able to survive, or even the IPL team is doing really badly because hardly you get stadium, and it's not about the population not being there. And then you have a city like small city in Kerala, and you have a 7-a-side match and you have 40,000 people watching that match. So it's not about the number of people in the city which you require, it's the number of crazy fanatics you have in the city who want to watch the football.
So,
the culture has to be changed in a way that they have to be. So, see, the ones who are watching the football in Mallapuram, they are not watching world-class football.
Yeah.
It's a nice time day out for them. It's a nice night out. It's the way of having fun. And the same way,
They have
full house stadiums in Calcutta, every person who's sitting in that Calcutta food house has spent 100 rupees for that match. So trust me, he's not that poor. He has a TV in his home. That means he has access to European football. But they're still seeing Indian football. So the culture. But how do you even make sure that this shift happens? Yes, you have to wait for the first Mohamed Salah, but improve the level of football we have in India. That means unless and until we make a concerted effort to improve the standard. And when I say standard, see, my pass to you is going to be at the same level. I mean, if I give a hardest pass I can and you'll receive it, it'll be at the same level as Messi passes. There's no difference in the speed.
Yeah.
Difference is what you do with the ball when you receive it. Hmm. The amount of time you take when you look up, you see that guy is free or that guy is free or the third time, the game is finished.
Exactly.
And that's what happens in India. So what we are trying to do with the World Cup 2034 match is create intelligent footballers. That means people who are also brainy. That means when I'm saying brainy, I don't mean engineers. I mean who can take decisions.
Witty.
So what we are doing in India is, if you ask a 20-year-old footballer who is, suppose somebody like a Narinder Gehlot or an Anwar Ali Jr. or even a Jackson Singh, their football career ends today, they would not be able to do anything else in their lives. And that has to be taken away. You have to be able to be okay in education and football.
Yes.
Unless you do that, your decision-making ability will suck. For example, the only difference between us and foreign football is, European football is, the decisions are taken two passes prior. That means I already know my three passing away options. So the moment the ball comes to me, there's no thinking. It's dead, tuck and tuck. That's why tiki-taka, tuck, 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 because decision making is so fast. That's what
they already know.
Yeah. Whereas in India, it's tiki and then taka. Okay? That is the only difference. Otherwise, their shot when somebody gives a free kick
or
shot is exactly the same as India's. The kind of goals we've scored in the I-League and the ISL this year are world-class goals.
Yes, yes, yes.
So it's not that our standard is poor. It's just these things which are making the difference.
So, sir, when we talk about these technical aspects, so we normally presume that such would be a result of a higher level of coaching or a better environment that they're in. So, what is the AIFF or what is the Indian football ecosystem doing to facilitate those sort of requirements so that we can eventually play the World Cup? Obviously,
Now they were fucking it up, man. Till now they were not doing anything. They've started spending money on Golden Baby Leagues now after start spending all the money on the ISL on the top. If they had done the Golden Baby Leagues 20 years ago, ISL would have happened on its own. It would have
exactly.
You need to put money and focus on the juniors in a very serious manner. So when you say in AIFF they have stupid rules like you have to have two developmental players in your squad, what the fuck does developmental players mean, man? That means you should have developed them, not buy them off academies. Developmental players means your academy has developed those players.
Exactly.
Do that. That means I know as an owner, 20% of my team is going to come from my academy. I'll definitely make my academy world class because 20% of my bloody team is going to come from there. Mm-hmm. So I'll make sure I work on it. That's how you do it. And then they have these young players. You have to have two under 23, 22 players in your team. Under 22, you are a senior man. 22
scoring goals.
Declining now.
Exactly. So
nowadays, you need to be in the first team by 17. And you need to be a prime at 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Those are your prime years. It's not 28, 29 anymore. Like,
you look at Mbappe.
Strikers, you know that he's on the decline now. 29, 30-year-old strikers are on the decline.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, you need to actually... And now what is happening is our youngsters... all our boys who are being selected, for example, we keep on blaming Manveer Singh for missing simple goals and being a stupid striker, but it's not his fault. He's exactly at the same level when I had him in second division and he was 18 then. But he has not improved. Why? Because there's been no game time.
Coaching.
Yeah. Now Vikram Pratap will have signed for some ISL club. He's not going to get game time there. Unless you have the 3+1 rule. If you have the 3+1 rule, guaranteed he'll get game time. So we are actually screwing ourselves. We're sitting on the branch and then we're cutting it off and then we're saying, how are we falling? If you don't give game time to your striker, then you keep on asking, where's the next Sunil Chhetri? That's a very stupid question to ask.